Sadly, y'all. Back at it again. My God, brother, he brought me back his Dodge Charger. 08 Dodge Charger, excuse me, these little upgrades. And well, the other thing is, too, is that before I put this radio in, y'all can see it right there. Pioneer WDN. Before I put this radio in, his dash was already gauges and all that, lights, all that was already messed up. So, even though he even took it, got it fixed or whatever, but people at the dealership said, I guess the radio, every time they put the radio back up, it's blowing the gauges. So, you know, these cars, the damn Chevys, they all notorious for, you know, electrical problems or whatever. So, what I'm end up having to do, just to even bypass it, I'm gonna just end up probably just hardwiring the switch power for the radio to the fuse box. I have to see what fuse I'm gonna use. That way that'll, you know, knock it out of even that being connected, you know, with the dash or whatever. So hopefully that'll work. And what else? I said he got a little upgrades he want me to do to it. And we ended up buying the 1200 watt kinetic car audio battery. We're buying a Clarion three-way crossover, RCAs for the crossover, trunk shocks for the trunk. It's a damn, let's see how it opens. The shocks on here, oh, just gone. You see it just gonna close, slam right down, so the hand's gonna work. And, about the corner bezels for the side markers on the headlights, put them in. And then he bought, because I actually put an HID kit on his low beams. I'm not rolling HIDs no more, no ballast and nothing like that. I'm rolling with these LED buds. They do just the same amount of power. I mean, HID is a little bit brighter, but same thing, man. You gotta have a ballast and nothing like that. And then they got built-in fans up in there, back up right there. They're being, so that's what I'm rolling with. And that's what I gotta do. But probably right now, I'm gonna put these shocks on this trunk or whatever, and then probably tomorrow night I'll probably start taking that out, figuring that radio out, and then getting the rest of this truck together, because they just tore stuff up, damn dealership, man. So I hit y'all another video. Alright, what's up, y'all? Turn off these trunk shocks. As you can see, got the one off. How it is, it goes in. It's a clip right here. Back on there, holes and all, see the bottom of this one. So I'm gonna take both of these off. Take this one off. I'm gonna take the other one out. Got a little one right here. So, come on out. Keep the old ones. Worn out. The new ones. And both on. Yeah, straight open, turn it up, hold it. No problem. Next, I gotta get all this up out of here, man. They messed with all this crap up, y'all. This wires every damn well. They messed some stuff up. About to start pulling all this out of here and get this looking neat again. I got something. I gotta, what I'm gonna do is that his amps, instead of them being horizontal, I mean vertical, they're vertical right now, I mean, but I turn them horizontal, so they'll be laying this way, instead of side by side, and that way I'll be able to get this crossover in here. So, what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna just take all this back apart, rerun it here. Had everything let off. Had it before. Can't believe he did this, man. So, give y'all an update. We're gonna start taking this all apart. Alright. Got the amps out. Y'all can see. I'm a little cluttered right now, but I got it all out. The brown block I had. Take all this out. Then I'm probably turn these amps side. Either horizontal like that. Turn it to the side like that. At an angle. So we'll see. We'll see about this. We'll see. Check it out. Got to load this up. Got the wires on over here. Screws and everything. This is how I'm gonna get the layout right here. Lay it out just like this. So I'll be able to mess with the gains. I'm gonna put the back seat back out. I'm gonna get all them wires tucked real nice and neat. I'm gonna drill some holes right through here for this. I'm gonna get that battery. Probably I'm gonna put back probably over here. Get over here, back right there on that corner behind the crossover. Probably back there. We'll see. This one look better. But that's how it's gonna look. I'm probably gonna put this back here. I'm gonna move the crossover all the way up here. Yeah. Cause the battery's up under here, so I ain't worried about no interference. Not from the wiring or nothing like that. You know, sometimes that's why you run your wires separate. RCA's remote wire on one side of the car, power wire on the other side of the car, but battery back here, so I ain't gotta worry about that. So I'm probably gonna put that battery right there in that spot, and then run them RCA's up here, with another thing gauge wire going down over here. Y'all see, man. Man, this done in no time. Alright, y'all know the video. You see, I'm real with my niggas. I kill for my niggas. I'm affiliated. Grew up from the battery up. Instructions or whatever. Man, that was a lot of stuff up in here, man, but I only had so much I'm doing. The rims for sale. All types of stuff, man. So, man, the garage, man, I got all types of stuff over there. So, those look like junk, but to me, it's productivity. Alright, but this the battery. That's out. So that's the back. So what's gonna happen? What's this side gonna look? Now, this side is gonna look. I'm gonna take this back seat out. And hold on. Focus. Okay. So what you do? Battery. It's gonna go right back there. Strap it down. Probably come up some right there. Cross over right there. That's just how it's gonna look. I might even turn it sideways. I don't know. Let me see. Might put it somewhere else. I don't know. But that's it. Might be a spot for the bank. So, we'll see. We'll see what happens. That's what I'm doing now. Back seat out. That's how I'm, everything mounted down. The amps, they mounted. This is how I'm gonna do this. I got my splitter. My power wire, and that's my splitter for my ground. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run a fuse. Fuse off of the battery going to this battery right here. I got to see it. The fuse, I'm probably gonna mount it up here somewhere. The fuse, power wire off of here. The fuse. another wire going to here. And the other wire that I'm gonna have ran is gonna go from here to that splitter right there. This I'm gonna try to pull this down, sand it down right there. Put another piece of ground right there, ground it out right there. Have separate grounds from being grounded on here. So separate that ground, and then all these should be straight with that splitter right there. And then the speaker wires. Speaker wires out there, just gotta hook back up, and then RCA's and everything, low wire. Then I have to run another wire and another baseline for this crossover. And that should be it for this trunk. So I'm gonna get down to that now. Gauge wire again. Got the crossover getting wired up now. Ground, power, remote, 12 volt coming off of the crossover. Now I'm just about to run this ground right here. And this ground to this right here. Well, y'all, yeah, everything is zip tied down. So for this one, I'm gonna do that again, zip tied. But it's coming together, and all I gotta do now is get a positive run to that battery, and another positive run to right here, the distribution block, and then it's gonna be on it proper. It's gonna sound good when I get done. It's real good. About to run the RCA's off the crossover to the amps. And like I said, once I do that, crossover. So output. I'm gonna have from the front and rear output. The input of the full channel. So now I'm about to do this battery. So a few blocks. Get this going. And I think I need to do this to me, boy. I want to do, bro. Knocking this out, man. I'll clockwork. Love doing this stuff. Y'all see, Rush. Gauge wire going behind here. I'm positive right there. I'm making another wire for this ground. I'm gonna run into the middle right there. So all the grounds will be separate. And then I have to still run this fuse block. That block right there. I'll be in the money. Get my ground made. Got my positive ready. Now I'm about to ground this to the bare metal. I'm gonna use my drill to do this though. It'll be easy. Use this wire brush. Scrape that to the metal. Get a self-tapper screw. About two or three of them. Put it in there. Hopefully. Battery be grounded. Got my paint scraped back. That's when I'm gonna ground this wire for this battery. I'm about to use these self-tapping screws and some battery terminal protector to protect it from corrosion. Got my ground made, as you can see. My paint scraped off. Self-tapping screw to wash it. Going nowhere. Now I got this battery terminal protector. I got my spray on there, so corrosion.